With an ageing and vulnerable water infrastructure, the constant repairs require an expensive and temporary solution to a long-term problem. So the country's local councils are looking to find money, save money, and also combine assets to achieve economies of scale. In the third part of this series on our water woes, One News Chief Correspondent John Campbell goes to Rangitikei, where they're asking, can towns share facilities to make them better?
So these were maps that my wife actually gave to me when I came into the job. I love her dearly, obviously. But we start out the coast.
Family and Rangitikei, the loves of Andy Watson's life. To stand with a map side is to hear geography made poetry.
And we come into Bulls, and slowly as we make our way through, you come up through our towns. So you get into the Martins and the Hunterbulls.
And on he goes, town to town, the story of the district and the country and of water.
Multiple towns, all requiring their own wastewater plants, drinking water plants.
Does localisation of cost work in underpopulated areas?
No.
We met Lower Hutmere Campbell Barry in the first story in our series. While the Wellington region has massive water issues, they're well known. He's worried that rural regions with smaller populations but similar water vulnerabilities are disappearing from view.
Without change, they are going to have astronomical rate rises, or they will have crap in their water, or they will have failing water treatment plants.
And our council faces these issues. Now, we're operating outside of compliance or consent on some of our plants, but at least we've negotiated a pathway and allowed funding to get there.
This, as you can see, is the wastewater treatment plant in Bulls. And this is the Martin wastewater treatment facility. Now, they're 14K apart. So Rangitikei is joining them together by pipe, which means that rather than struggling to keep two plants compliant, they can do one plant really well.
We believe that we have a responsibility for three waters. We need to be compliant. We need to remove our wastewater streams from going to our beautiful awa. Thai happy.
Ta-da!
And unfortunately...
Yes, here's the problem. Sometimes a community is so far from its neighbours that they aren't even on the map.
And our current plant there is not compliant. We exceed the borders of limitations within our consents.
It seems so simple. Collect the water, keep wastewater out of it, get it into pipes and then to your taps. And yet...
It has been a ticking time bomb for New Zealand, and the fuse is getting very short.